टुडे टॉपिक इज एस्फारविरिडी. इट्स अ डीएनए वायरस ग्रुप एंड इट्स स्ट्रक्चर इज इट्स अ डबल स्ट्रैंडेड डीएनए वायरस एंड इट कंटेन्स कॉम्प्लेक्स कैप्सिड विथ एंड इट name it its name is Aspharviridae. Aspar stands for African swine fever and related viruses. Family Aspharviridae contains a single genus Aspivirus, and African swine fever virus is the type species. It is a large enveloped double stranded DNA virus with complex icosahedral symmetry, and it is the only DNA virus which is arbovirus. Arbovirus means it's a virus which is transmitted through the arthropods, and its replication also occurs in soft ticks of the genus Ornithodorus, which is a biological vector. Means it gets involved in the transmission of the virus, and it's a thermolabile virus and sensitive to lipid solvent. And temperature range at which it is stable is 4 to 20 degrees centigrade. And pH range, it is stable for at 4 pH or 13 pH for several hours. But virus may persist for years in refrigerated meat. Its replication occurs primarily in the cytoplasm, but the nucleus is also needed for the replication of viral DNA. And DNA is transcribed by a virion associated DNA dependent RNA polymerase, and virus DNA is present in the nucleus soon after the infection. So the term nucleocytoplasmic is used for the replication, means the some part of the virus replication also involves nucleus of the host, so it is nucleocytoplasmic. And entry of the virus is through the receptor mediated endocytosis, and the release of the virus is through the budding or cellular disintegration. Coming to the disease African swine fever, there is no report of the disease in India, but it is endemic disease in African countries, and it affects domestic swine and wild swine. And two types of the pattern it is having for the transmission. One is sylvatic cycle, which involves the wild pig like warthogs and bush pig in Africa, and it involves sticks. And there is another one, domestic cycle, which is epizootic and endootic cycles, which occurs in domestic swine. Sylvatic cycles involve the soft ticks of the Ornithodorus, and it causes inapparent infections in the warthogs and the bush pigs. Sylvatic cycle, young warthogs are affected and develops viremia, and it acts as a source of virus for the ticks. Ticks are biological vector, means virus gets transmitted both through transovarial and through the different stages of the development, that is transstadial. Virus is excreted in the tick saliva and other excretions of the ticks, and infected ticks lives for several years without taking any blood meal. And after each blood meal, tick is capable to transmit virus to another swine. Old pigs are not viremic. This picture depicts the transmission of the African swine fever virus between the virus tick and pigs. One is domestic cycle, another is sylvatic cycle. In sylvatic cycle, through warthog or bush pig to another bush pig gets affected, or warthogs get affected, involving the soft tick. In domestic cycle, pig also gets infected through the bite of the ticks. Apart from this, in domestic cycle, like contaminated materials or direct contact also involves for the transmission. In domestic cycle, pigs get infected through the bite of the ticks or through the consumption of the tissue which are infected with the pigs or warthogs with virus. And virus is present in large quantity in nasopharyngeal excretion during the onset of clinical disease, or in other excretion also virus is present. So the mode of spread will be ingestion of the uncooked meat through direct contact or through the contact of the blood, which results due to the fighting. Indirect contact due to the fomites, vehicles or footwears. Coming to the pathogenesis, virus initially replicates in the pharyngeal mucosa, tonsil or inguinal lymph nodes, and it spreads to the bloodstream, and from the bloodstream it go to the other lymph node, bone marrow, spleen, lung, liver and kidneys, and there it develops secondary viremia, and from there it affects mainly to the lymphoreticular system, also megakaryocytes, endothelial cells, renal epithelial cells and hepatocytes. So the infection of the domestic pigs results in the leukopenia, lymphopenia and thrombocytopenia. It also causes apoptosis of the lymphocytes and mononuclear phagocytic cells. Swine may become persistently infected without even showing a clinical symptom. Or disease may range from the inapparent to per-acute or chronic infections, and symptoms mainly relate to the challenged dose, virulence of the virus or route of the infection. Coming to the disease, as I told, there are four types of the disease. Either inapparent infection may occur, per-acute infection occurs, acute infection or chronic infections occur. In per-acute cases, pig dies without showing any prominent clinical signs. Acute disease is manifested by fever, appetence, depression, recumbency, cutaneous hyperemia, or in some cases, hemorrhages. Dyspnea may occur, conjunctivitis, diarrhea, and in some cases, bleeding from the nose and rectum occurs. Pregnant pigs get aborted, and in this acute disease, mortality rate is very high, and sometimes cyanotic area develops on the ears, limbs, and extremities. Coming to the lesions of the acute diseases, lesions are seen in spleen, which gets enlarged, and lymph nodes, gastrohepatic lymph node and renal lymph nodes get swollen and hemorrhagic. Subcapsular petechia are seen in the kidney, and hemorrhages are also seen on the serosal surfaces. Edema of the lungs develops and hydrothorax develops. Chronic disease is manifested as cutaneous ulcers, pneumonia, pericarditis, pleuritis, arthritis, and inappetence. This picture depicts the clinical signs. In first picture, you see cyanosis of the ear and the mouth. Head region is seen. In second picture, hemorrhages are seen. In third picture, enlargement and hemorrhagic gastrohepatic lymphs are seen. And fourth picture, it shows the enlarged and hemorrhagic spleen. Diagnosis. Diagnosis can be done with the help of shown symptoms, but the correct diagnosis needs isolation or other confirmatory measures. For the diagnosis, suitable samples are blood, serum, tonsil, spleen, and lymph node. Virus isolation can be done in swine bone marrow or peripheral blood leukocyte culture. Immunofluorescence staining of the tissue, smears or frozen tissue can be done. ELISA, immunoblotting, and CFT can be used for the diagnosis, and PCR is also used for the diagnosis. Coming to the prevention and control. Prevention and control involve the restriction of the pig movement, serological monitoring of the carrier pigs, prevention of the contact between the domestic pigs and the wild pigs, slaughter of the infected pigs, proper cooking of the garbage before feeding, and also the eradication of the tick species, which acts as a vector for the African swine fever.